Hi everyone, I wonder how you're doing in these really strange times as they continue. I wonder how you're coping. I hope you're doing well. And I wonder how you're passing the time. I know some of us are really, really busy right now. Others of us have got a bit more time at the moment. I wonder what your lockdown reading has been like. At the beginning of lockdown, I was reading a couple of books. This is one of them, Crazy Love, by Francis Chan. I really like Francis Chan's writing. He just loves God. He cannot get over God's amazing, abundant, crazy love for you and for I. And when I read a book like this, it really stokes the passion in me to just look once again and marvel at God's love for us. And his love for Jesus is infectious. Really recommend Francis Chan's writing. I was reading that book, but I was also reading another book at the same time. This is a book you probably won't find in many Christian bookshops, Jurassic Park. I love the Jurassic Park books and films. I love the first film in particular, directed by Steven Spielberg. I love the story. I love the drama of it, and I love the characters. I love the observation in Jurassic Park of the potential in human beings for creative good, but also for destruction. I love the characters, of course. Characters like John Hammond, the visionary owner of the park, who finds out how to create dinosaurs from bits of DNA that he's found in old fossils. And his vision to build this theme park so that other people can come, the public can visit and see living dinosaurs for themselves. I love the character of Dr. Ian Malcolm, played by Jeff Goldblum, who says at one point, the scientists on the island were so busy doing what they could do as they were creating dinosaurs that they never stopped to actually ask the question, should they be doing it? It's a brilliant line. And the main characters that I want to think about today are Dr. Alan Grant, who's a paleontologist, who is sent to determine and investigate the park to see, is this park going to be safe for the public when it opens? Spoiler alert, it wasn't safe. And Tim and Lex, who are the grandchildren of John Hammond, the owner of the park, and they get caught up in the drama of this film. Thinking of a particular scene where Dr. Grant and these two children have been running from some dinosaurs that are attacking them, and Dr. Grant is rescuing the kids. I think there's a Tyrannosaurus Rex involved. They're running for their lives, and they run and run and run, and eventually it seems they escape the danger, at least for now. And they find themselves in front of a tall, large tree, and they climb up it, climb up to the very top, and they find themselves at the top, looking down, and they're above all the harm, above all that was chasing after them. They're safe just for the moment. The branches and the leaves of the tree surround them, wrap themselves around them, and the kids snuggle into the arms of Dr. Grant. And Dr. Grant says to the kids, I'm going to keep my eyes open tonight. I'm going to keep watching out for danger. And the kids, safe in his arms, snuggle down and go to sleep. Now, why am I going on about Jurassic Park? You may well ask. Well, some of you know that I love the Psalms. I was reading Psalm 91 the other day. I was intending on reading the whole Psalm, but I couldn't get past the first verse. I just couldn't get beyond it. It just seemed so good, and there was so much in it. I want to share it with you now. Psalm 91, verse 1. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. What a fantastic picture the psalmist paints for us there, of dwelling in God's shelter and finding rest in his shadow. It reminds me a little bit of that scene in Jurassic Park, of just having a bit of respite from all that is chasing after us. I wonder if you're feeling chased after today. We're invited to dwell in the shelter of the Most High. What does it mean to dwell? Well, it means to live there, make it our home. And often, as in the case from the scene in Jurassic Park, we need to move to that place. We need to travel. Maybe it involves climbing, but it certainly needs moving. Maybe it's just the positioning of our hearts or some kind of mental traveling. to position ourselves well to receive God's love. Doesn't mean we have to work hard to earn God's love, but we want to position ourselves to be in a place where we can receive God's love. That's what it means to dwell in his shelter. I wonder how well positioned you feel today to receive God's abundant love for you. The King James Version puts this verse like this. It says, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty." This shelter that we're invited to dwell in isn't just any old shelter. It's the secret place of God Almighty. It's the intimate presence of the Lord who is over all, the potentate of time, as the hymn puts it. That means the one who has supreme power and position to rule over all for all time, the Almighty One. And we're invited to climb up into the arms of the potentate of time, who is also our loving Father and beckons us to come and find true peace and rest in him. The promise is when we dwell in the shelter of the Most High, that we will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. We will find rest from all that is worrying us, from all that we can, all that we're afraid of. It's a break, a respite from being chased and pursued. What an amazing picture. To rest under his shadow. Just picture a hot, sunny day. We've had a few of them in the last few weeks where the sun is beating down and it becomes unbearably hot. And you find a large tree and you can sit under the shade of the branches just to get some respite and rest from that constant heat bearing down upon you. Or maybe resting in the shadow of God is to live in the shadow of the cross, reminding us that God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. As I say, we need not be afraid of dinosaurs chasing after us at the moment, but it does feel like there's plenty of other things chasing us at the moment, doesn't it? Fighting for our attention, trying to frighten us, to scare us, to worry us, to cause us grief, to have a hold over us. So right now, I invite you to close your eyes and just in your mind's eye to try and picture what's causing you anxiety at the moment. Just try and picture, it may represent something for you. What are you running from? Or maybe what's running towards you that you cannot seem to escape right now? Just picture it and name it before the Lord, before our Heavenly Father. He loves it when we bring our concerns, our anxieties to him. As you name it before the Lord, in your imagination, see that tall oak tree right in front of you and climb to the very top of it, where you find God, your Heavenly Father, looking down over everything. And he sees it all. He sees the good and he sees the bad. He sees the creative and he sees the destructive. He rules over it all. He's the potentate of time. But his eyes turn to you and he beckons you. And like a young child, you sit with him, safe in his embrace, in his arms, high above all the pain and the confusion of the world. You can simply sit and rest. Find rest from worrying. Find rest from running. And as you sit there, I'll speak these words over you from the end of Psalm 91. "Because you love me, says the Lord, I'll rescue you. I'll protect you, for you acknowledge my name. You'll call on me and I will answer you. I'll be with you in trouble. I will deliver you and honour you. With long life, I will satisfy you. I will show you my salvation." Lord, in these strange, frightening, confusing and uncertain days, we thank you that your love is constant. We thank you for your protection over us, Lord. And we ask that you'd help us to position ourselves well to know and to receive your abundant, outrageous love for us. Lord, help us to dwell in your shelter, that we may rest in your shadow and find peace. Peace the world does not offer, but true peace that comes from you. Help us, Lord, to rest in your shadow. In Jesus' name, amen. One of the reasons I love this psalm is that it reminds me of the day that Nick and I got married, which is 25 years ago this year. And during our wedding service, we sang a song which is the words of Psalm 91 put to music by Chris Bowater. And I'd just like to finish by sharing that with you now.
Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. Will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. And I'll say of the Lord, He is my refuge. I'll say of the Lord, He is my strength. I'll make of the Most High One my dwelling place. I'll say He is my God. I'll say He is my God. I will say He is my God, in whom I trust. My God, I will say He is my God.